Hi, René here. Would you like to see what happened before this review? You can relax now, the dangerous part is over. The secret is revealed. My new weapon against Cayin and others is the Accuphase DP-430. It was launched in 2017 and was replaced by the DP-450 last year. The price of about 5,500 euros fortunately was not raised, but if you are willing to pay double the price, you get the DP-570, which is even better. In this review, you will have to put up with the discontinued model, but even this player still got what it takes. The sound and build quality in comparison with the Cayin is like Benz versus Toyota, but this is what you can expect with regard to the double price. My reviews mostly are not about counting peas. The focus of my attention is always to find out how much higher do you have to set the bar to achieve an easily audible improvement. And this miserably always ends up with an exponential curve. Double the price will only yield a 10 to 20% increase in sound quality. Transport and DAC can be used separately, as it is the case with most of the recent devices, so we have a variety of digital in and outputs, and we can choose between balanced and unbalanced analog outputs. The XLR outputs, however, are only fake ones for those who want to use XLR inputs on their preamp. If we want to use a digital source like a streamer, we can switch inputs on the remote and we can adjust the volume to match it with that of other sources. The display will show you the sampling rate and the bit rate when you use the onboard DAC. The tray slides out like the cabin door of a spaceship of 2050 and not like this. The remote is as long as that of the CS100, but a little wider, a bit thicker and also heavier, And it is surprising how much of a haptic difference is caused by these details. Contrary to the Cayin remote, click action is so distinct that you will never be startled by being presented the wrong track. Trifles like these are pleasant gimmicks, but what really counts is the sound. So let's jump into the sonic qualities. Sarah K, Made in the Shade, track 10, Don't I Know You from Somewhere. Playing the track over the Cayin, the sounds of the harp strings reminded me of a Star Wars episode, because there was zipping and whirring between my speakers like laser rays discharged from spaceships gone out of control. The CS-100 cannot handle the differences in the intensity of the string vibrations, while the Accuphase could handle the microdynamics correctly, and therefore depict a lifelike and much smaller harp which did not blur the singer's voice or other instruments. In track 9, Sizzling, it's getting tougher because of the sonic characteristics of some unusual instruments. The bass is more controlled and cleaner. The bongos on the left have a deeper resonance point, more volume, a heftier bite. The Hammond organ can be pinpointed deeper on the stage, and the reed instrument called duduk is more focused and detailed. Carmen Suite. The DP-430 at first divides the orchestra and the percussion group with razor-sharp clarity, but then again it somehow manages to weave them together again, like a master of weft and thread technique, so that interdepending details are exposed, many of which I had never noticed before. For example, the linking of some taps on a small drum with the clicking of bows on the bodies of some violins. Even more interesting is the art of recreating the delicate balance in Harold Faberman's Concerto for Jazz Drummer and Symphony Orchestra. Here it's all about live and let live in music. Me, the drums, I'm a great pike, but I let the shoal of sardines, the musicians of the orchestra, swim according to their intricate designs. On the other hand, there are drums and swirls which hit the stomach, but they don't rip the wallpaper from the walls, a boldness the Cayin sometimes does not hesitate to commit. I admit that at first I thought the CS-100 could raise hell more overwhelmingly and convincingly, but when you think twice, you must admit it is not very likely that the idea of a drums and orchestra composition was to sacrifice and sweep away the whole orchestra. There should be a minimum of coexistence. Verdi, Luisa Miller. In my humble opinion, opera should best be enjoyed on vinyl. But I concede not everybody still has a turntable at home, but might get in the mood for some opera tunes at home. In this case, it's good to have a device like the 430 at hand. Arias gush out energetically. The orchestra is presented like a landscape on a three-dimensional map, and occasional rock formations are neatly layered like a lasagna or a wedding cake. The final, which goes down on you like a scene from a blockbuster about doomsday, is still like a sturdy wall of granite blocks. The walls like scrubbing of the deep strings and double basses, which the Cayin foreshadows only feebly like an echo of the real thing, will forcefully sweep over you and emotionally carry you away when you hear it with the Accuphase. And the trio, which the CS100 can turn into a blowtorch during the simultaneous outcry of the three actors with the Accuphase, remains what it is, a heartbreaking operatic effect. The Moor has done his duty, the Moor can go. And the better is the fine of the good. For its price tag, the CS100 is not bad, but the 430 was the clear winner. It plays in a higher league, which is not only about detail improvements, but tries to convey music on a more holistic level, which at least aims at sophisticated perfection and emotion too. I think I have climbed up at least three rungs of the ladder towards more high-end perfection, maybe even four rungs when I throw my tuning effort with a live audio damper feed into the balance. Why do I think so? Let's take a look behind the scenes. A considerable part of the highlighted improvements achieved with the DP-450 is due to the damping measurements due to the vibration management. For example, the reduction from 7 modules to only 2, damping the vibrations of the laser unit with 4 viscoelastic feet and lowering the point of gravity, shielding of motor vibrations, etc. So we see most of the improvements are in the field of damping measurements and unhitching all parts from each other. You cannot update a DP-430 to this level of damping technology, but you can outweigh them with a simple hack. And that is using high-grade damper feet. At least for me, it worked to a considerable degree and the clarity of music reproduction made a leap forward. Not only the 5 P's I showed you in the beginning, but a whole bunch of them. I was able to hear that, and I don't care if some naysayers mock about it and voice a suspicion that the reviewer just smoked a little bit too much.